What is the worst thing you've overheard while pretending to be asleep? When I was a kid, I used to be scared of monsters or something creeping up on me in my sleep. So I would always ask my dad to check on me before he went to bed. It made me feel more comfortable. One night, I was still awake when I heard him coming up the stairs. And I wasn't supposed to be awake and knew I would get in trouble if he saw me. So I pretended to be asleep. He came into my room and just kinda stared at me for a few seconds. Then came up close to my bed, lifted the blanket up, farted under it, turned around and left. It's been at least 15 years and I remember that night vividly. He vehemently denies it to this day, but I know what happened. My theory on this is he knew you weren't sleeping and wanted to teach you a lesson. I pretended to sleep through the doctor sitting at my kitchen table telling my dad he had stage 3 cancer. I was 9. He's totally fine now. But it really sucked at the time. That's an awesome doctor to come to your home to deliver that kind of news. Glad your dad kicked cancer's ass. My father telling my mother that sometimes he just wanted to kill me. I was 5 years old when I overheard this. Being that my dad was an alcoholic and full of rage, I believed him and lived my entire childhood believing he was going to kill me. My dad was and still is an alcoholic. Similar things have happened to me. I tried almost everything to correct stuff between us, but alcohol is more important to him. Nowadays, I rarely see him, and when I do, I hate to be around him for long. Freshman college roommate watching porn on his laptop wearing headphones. Humping his mattress like there's no tomorrow. Damn. I remember humping my mattress. I didn't know what jerking off was at the time. Lmao. Sleeping over at a friend's house when I was 14. All of us on the floor in living room. Cold and sleep. Two of my friends, guy and girl, directly next to me start doing freaky things to each other. I was extremely shy and a couple of years younger than them, so I stayed quiet and hoped they'd stop. Had to listen to them for an hour while she made weird ass moaning squeaky noises and he was singing in a weird slightly whispery singy voice Matchbox 20 songs to her while he did whatever he was doing. That was last time I slept over at a friend's house. Lmao, that is weird as duck. What? You don't sing during sex? That I was dying with meningitis, but jokes on the doctors, I'm still kicking. You ever live just to flex on the haters? My grandparents won $10,000 at the casino, and they told all of their children, and presumably gave them some of that money, except my dad. My dad is a dick, so I didn't tell him either. My friends talking about going into my wallet later, and steal my money, and then leave before I notice. I kicked them out. Some friends huh. No wonder people at school think he's gay. My stepmom. My stepdad thought I was gay from the ages 16 to 19. Based on the fact, when I got my driver's license I wasn't out 24/7 chasing tail. I had people at my old job thinking I was a closeted gay because I didn't try to date or get laid with random women. Some people just have low sex drives, you know. But no. It's like there's two sexual orientations. Fuck everything that moves. And gay. Apostrophe. My mom and I were sharing a hotel room on a trip and unfortunately only had one bed, so we had to share that too. As I was trying to fall asleep, I kept hearing the text tone from my mom's phone going off and her giggling. My parents hate each other, so I knew it wasn't my dad she was texting with. Curious. I opened my eyes just a little bit to see that she was flirting with other men while on a trip with her family, and I was in fact staring at a dick pic. I couldn't really go back to sleep after that. My older brother in the next room, when he snuck a girl in. They had sex for about a minute, and then I could hear him apologizing for about 20. May not be the worst ever, but it's definitely the funniest. Probably the funniest was on a camping trip with the boys. I have sleep apnea and use a CPAP machine. I overheard a couple of my mates talking about smoking a joint and hotboxing me through the air intake of my CPAP machine. Probably my dad's dementia screaming. Usually nothing is wrong. But he'll wake up at 4 or 5 in the morning to yell at God and grind his teeth. You never did get used to it. My mum's boyfriend sloppily trying to duck my mum all drunk as shit whilst we're all sharing the same ducking hotel room. I was 13. That just brought back a memory for me too. I can't remember how old I was. Somewhere between 10 and 14. Sharing a room on holiday and same thing happened. Was a great holiday until that point. I remember coughing to try and get them to stop but they didn't. You can come on my tits or my belly, but not inside me. This was coming from the top bunk. I was on the bottom bunk. I snuck out and went somewhere else. Not me, but my wife heard her boyfriend having sex with her best friend. This was obviously long before we met. I was about to say WTF. I was at my BF's apartment staying over. His roommate also happened to have some friends who were dating there as well. I was in my BF's room and they were sleeping in the living room. They were definitely ducking. Weirdest thing of it all were these literal banging sounds. Like someone was hitting the ducking wall. The whole time I had to piss like a mother ducker, but getting to the bathroom involved walking by the living room and I did not wanna risk it. T. When we woke up the next morning, someone had ripped a chunk out of one of the curtains and the TV remote was snapped in half. F. To this day I don't wanna know what was going on in there. Plot twist, she's actually the Hulk, but instead of transforming when she's angry, she transforms when horny. I was a camp counselor. Two girls very much like to make hot or not lists. One of them suggested a male counselor was hot, and the other said he was saying mean things about me behind my back, which made him not hot. Hurt to hear that from my campers, but glad they supported me. Or what, that's actually sweet. Good on them. When I was a kid, I was pretending to sleep in the car. I was in the back seat, next to my older sister. I was probably 6 or 7. So she would have been around 13. She let out a raunchy, all windows down. Gag, the rest of the car sort of fart. It was loud, but we were both in the back. She immediately blames it on me farting in my sleep. The whole car laughs and rolls down their windows. And I stayed asleep. No one to this day knows that it was her, and she still thinks she got away with it. I got you, C's. When I was a wee tot, I pretended to be asleep in the family room, so I wouldn't have to actually go to bed, and once my parents were distracted, I could keep watching TV. I then got to hear my dad proposition my mom for couch sex. It's been many years, so I don't remember exactly what he said, but it was something along the lines of hop on pop. Apostrophe. Hatter OMG, that's horrifying. My sister's soon-to-be fiancé wanking while saying her name. At least he wasn't saying someone else's name. Solid commitment to wank over your partner. This is a case of next to everything else in this thread. This looks positively heartwarming. Who knew a proper wank could show such integrity? Question mark? My mom trying to calm my dad down out of a suicidal fit. My brother and I had been really bad that day, and when he grounded us, we both told him that we hated him and wanted him to go away. He didn't do anything wrong. My brother and I were just a couple of immature little cunts. D. I'm pretty sure blackout drunk at this point, which I had never seen and still haven't saw since then. Walked into our room that night and I pretended to fall asleep. Then he just started these deep, haunting sobs that I'll probably never forget. He stumbled outside, and we could hear him begging my mom to let him die, and sobbing all I've ever wanted in my entire life was to be a better dad than mine. I was only 11 or so, but it ducking destroyed my heart. I think that's the time I learned that emotional pain can actually physically hurt. I was hunched over in my bed bawling my eyes out, and on the verge of throwing up. I also felt like an asshole for crying over what we said. My brother was thankfully able to sleep through it all. I think about that once every 2 weeks or so, and I always message him to tell him I love him when I do. I hope he forgot about it, but being a dad myself now, I don't think it's something you totally forget. It might not hurt like it did in the moment, but I don't think you forget, like most heartbreaking things, I guess. My family were staying at a friend's house and had to share a room. My dad comes to bed hammered and says to my mum something along the lines of, "Does it impress you that I'm this drunk and can still perform?" I actually wanted to die. Wow, reading this gave me bystander desire for death. Glad you made it through that one. The person in the bunk under me beating his dick like it owed him money. Something like, "She's too old for this. I'm not going to carry her up to bed anymore." And that was the last time I was magically transported from the living room couch to my bedroom. My roommate's one-night stand dismount because his dick was hitting her bladder and she waddled off for a piss before getting back on top. Please click subscribe if you enjoyed this video.